Welcome to my channel on numerical methods in civil engineering. Like, share, subscribe, press bell button for latest update. So let us take another example. Okay. This is another example. Find the area of bending moment diagram of simply supported beam loaded as shown in the figure for the following data. So W is equal to 30 kilonewton per meter, length L is equal to 10 meter, A is equal to 2 meter, B is equal to 4 meter, and C is equal to 4 meter. Consider interval of finding the coordinates as 1 meter. Okay, am I audible, all of you?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so let me complete this class. Okay, if required, I will repeat and do the class for other people. So because anyhow we have started, let us not waste the time. Okay, this is another example where you have a simply supported beam with a partial UDL. Okay, you have a partial UDL here. So here also, the same procedure has to be followed. Okay, just need to find the reactions. Okay, like this, you have to take out. Yeah. So R1 and R2. R1 will be nothing but reaction one, and by applying equations of equilibrium, we will get R1 as WB by 2L into 2C plus B. So that you know, right? Sigma Fy is equal to 0, sigma Fx is equal to 0. If you consider R1 plus R2 is equal to W into B, you will get it, okay? So W is the intensity of the load. So W into B you will get. So that divided by 2, you will get it, okay? So this is the reaction. Now V1 is equal to WB by 2L into 2C divided, plus B. You know how we get it? Get this one? It's nothing but do you remember the formula? If you have a beam and if you have a point load at a distance A and this is B, what is RA? RA equation if W is the load. Anybody? Hello? 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 Can you able to hear me?
Yes.
Yeah. So actually speaking, this is how it will be calculated. So total load WB will be acting here. Okay. And this will be nothing but B by 2. Okay. And this will be B by 2. This side, there will be B by 2. So, the total distance here, this side will be A plus B by 2, and similarly this side it will be C plus B by 2. Okay, so this A will be equal to, over here this A will be equal to A plus B by 2 in the, okay, and here B will be, this B will be equal to C plus B by 2. Okay, and now if you substitute this formula, you will get this one. So that's nothing but W is equal to, in this one, W small w into B. Okay, this is a general beam, and if you apply this beam over here, so it will be W. Now this is A and this is B, right? So if you simplify and calculate it, you will get this formula. Okay, let me just show you. So W, the formula, what is the RA equation? Do you remember? RA is equal to, in this case of problems, W AB by L, you know, right? So W by W into A plus 2B by L, you know that formula, right? Here you have the W. Hello. WB by L and WA by L. Okay, that formula you can consider. So RA will be nothing but WB divided by L. Okay, so you just substitute here the value of B, which is nothing but C plus B by 2. So if you solve that, RA will get it equal to WB into what is that B? C plus B divided by 2. Okay, and so divided by L. So if you simplify, what will be there? RA is equal to WB into, so this will go to the numerator, 2C plus B divided by L into 2. All of you clear? You understood? No. You know this formula, right? If you have a simple beam with a point load, the reaction RA will be equal to WB by L and RB will be equal to WA by L. So same formula I've used. So you get RA is equal to WB into 2C plus B divided by 2L. Same equation, you'll get it. Similarly, R2 will also be, you'll be getting it. So that's nothing but R2 will be equal to A by L. So where A is equal to A plus B by 2. You substitute it, you finally will get the value of R2 as this. Are you clear? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Okay. It's very simple as the, regular class. Okay. Regular simply supported beam. Okay. Now, so after having this R1 and R2, then the procedure is same. So you can find out moment at X equation and use that MX equation, substitute the values of X, get different ordinates, and using those ordinates, apply trapezoid rule, you can calculate the area. But thing is here, you can, the problem here is, so you have, unlike in the case of previous problem, you need only one section, because the load is same throughout the length. Okay, so you need only one section. If you take, that is sufficient. Whereas in the present problem, because here you have you have load only in this region. Okay. This section is different, and this section is different, and this section is different. So you need to take three sections. Okay, one section you should consider here, and you should have one MX. So if you consider between this zero to A, you will have this as the MX equation. MX is equal to between this two, there is no load. So therefore, bending moment at X is equal to R1 into X. Clear? Yes, isn't it?
Yes, sir.
Okay. And similarly, then you should consider. Yeah. So this is the first one. That's how you can find out a moment at X in this equation, in this region. Similarly, you consider one more section in B portion. Okay. Section here between A to B, there is one more portion from this point to this point, that will be different. So we need one more MX equation. So M at X can be obtained by, how do you find? Just like in case of strength of metals, the same way you should do it. Therefore, here the bending moment at this point at X will be equal to R1 into X, okay, minus, okay, you have this portion W by 2, or actually speaking WB by 2 into the distance. That's nothing but A plus B by 2. That formula will be there, or X minus A also you can use. Okay, from here. So if you simplify, finally you will get this formula. Okay, so that is another equation. bending moment at x equation. Next thing is you consider the third section over here. In the third section, in this third section, the moment at x can be obtained directly from here, from right hand side. Okay, so that's nothing. Instead of considering r1 and this, you just consider r2. Therefore, m at x will be equal to r2 into l minus x. Okay, if this is x from here to here, okay, for the third section, if from here to here, if it is x, so from here to here, it will be l minus x. Okay, therefore, bending moment at x will be equal to r2 into this l minus x. R2 into l minus x. So these are the three equations for moment at x equation. So using these equations, what we should do is we should find out the bending moment over here. Bending moment at different locations. Okay, let us do that. So for the first region, m at x, m at 0 will be 0 only. Directly you can calculate and put it. M1, moment at 1 is nothing, because in this problem, the A is from 0 to 2 meters, okay? 0 to 2 meter, and B starts from 2 to 6 meters, and C starts from 6 to 4, ends at 10, 6 to 10, okay? Therefore, the range will be from, you know, RA, 0 to A is nothing but 0 to 2 meters, okay? And A to B is nothing but 2 to 6 meters, okay? And B to C is nothing but 6 to 10 meters, okay? And now at 1 meter, so first equation will be valid, R1 into X. So what is R1? 72. So using the above equations, actually, this R1 and R2 equations, we could able to get R1 and R2. That I've done it in this problem, actually. I'll share this all of you. Okay. So you have UDL at only in the partial area, partial length. So I have calculated, and you will get it equal to R1 is equal to 72, and R2, this is actually R2. R2 will be equal to 48, and this is the bending moment diagram. Okay, before, let me not go into that. Okay, so moment at x1 will be nothing but R1 into x. R1 is 72, 72 into 1. So that will be 72. So next R2, moment at 2 will be 72 into 2. So that is M1, Mx in the range of when x is lesser than a. Next, when x is greater than a, but less than a plus b, that means here, this point between this region from a to b region. Okay. So what will be the equation? R1 into x. So R1 is 72 into what is x? X is nothing but 3 now, because we are calculating the interval, the bending moments at 1 meter intervals. Okay. R1 into 3. Okay. Minus W. What is the value of W given? 30, isn't it? In our problem, the value of W is 30. Okay. So W by 2 into X minus A. X is 3. I'm sorry. X is 3 meters. And what is A? 2 meters. Whole square. Okay. So to the power 2, so that will give you the bending moment at the third point, 3 meter point. Okay, so that will be somewhere here. Okay, so the value of that can be obtained here. Okay, I've calculated already. So 72 into 2 at 2 meter, 72 into 2, 144, and this is actually as per this formula. Okay, R1 into X minus W by 2 into X minus A formula. So that is this way I've calculated all the values up to 6. Okay, so these are the values I can I've already listed out here in the next page. Okay, so at 1 to 2, actually this bit should be above there. Okay, from 1 to 2 it will be A region, and from 3 to 7 the other region. Okay, so these are the values, right? And having these values, I have plotted the Bendemann diagram. Actually, you need not plot in the you need to draw, and you just need to show the values. Okay, and this is which indicates the trapezoids, number of trapezoid, and you should number. Okay, so this is actually M1, M0, M1, M2, M3, M4, M5, M6, M7, M8, M9, and M10. So there will be 10 values of bending moments. Okay, so these are the bending moment values which you need to calculate by substituting the x values in these three equations. Now actually we did using this equation, mx is equal to the second equation till here. Next, similarly from the length 6 to 10 you need to use another equation, that's nothing but rt into l minus x. Use this equation, right, and find out the bending moments at length is equal to 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay, bending moment values. So after, at the end of the calculations, you will arrive at these values. Okay, at every 1 meter you will have bending moment values, and you just plot those values. You draw actually it's a, will it be a cubic parabola or just parabola? Anybody, what will be the shape of this, parabola or cubic parabola?
Cubic parabola, sir.
Is it so? No. You will have x square only, right? Cubic means x cube will be there. It's a UDL. In previous problem, like in case of simply supported with UVL, then that will be cubic parabola. Okay. Right? You're clear, right?
Yes, sir.
X cube, if it is there, then that will be cubic parabola. X square, if it is there, that will be just parabola, normal parabola. Okay. And here in this between, there will be a straight line in between this. Okay. Only cubic parabola will be, parabolic portion will be there in between this. These portions will be straight line portions. Okay. The remaining portions will be straight lines. Okay. That way, you will complete these bending moment calculation or bending moment ordinates. So you'll end up with these values, okay, and plot them. And now the area, what will be the area? How do we calculate area?
H by 2.
Yeah,
so H by 2
formula,
into
this formula you can use it directly, H by 2 or H into, simplified formula is H into first ordinate, M0 by 2 plus M1 plus M2 plus M3 till M9, and then plus M10 divided by 2. That is the formula. So I'll just show you. I will substitute and we'll see what the value will get it. So H is, how much will be the H here? What is H here? What is H mean? H is nothing but interval, right? See here. H here is nothing but interval, isn't it?
Yes,
H is interval, and y naught and all those are actually the ordinates. Okay, so considering them in this problem, so H is nothing but, what is H here?
Interval, sir.
Yeah, how much is the interval in our problem? Because total length of the beam was, see here, what is the total length of the beam? 10 meter.
10 meters.
It is, we are asked to, they have asked to find ordinates at every, taking ordinate at every 1 meter interval.
1 meter.
So 1 meter is the H value. Or actually speaking, what you can do, 10 divided by 10, whatever. So length is 10, so 10 intervals will be there. Or directly you can just say 1 meter, because you know directly. 1 into, so Y1 is, this is the Y1, so 0 divided by 2. Plus Y1 is 72. Okay. Plus 144. Plus
201.
Yeah, you just repeat, tell me. Yeah.
Plus 228.
Plus
225.
225 plus
192.
192 plus
144.
144 plus
96.
96 plus
48.
48 plus 0. 0 divided by 2, isn't it?
2.
Because the last ordinate will be half, only one will be there. Okay. So by this, you will be getting the total area of this bending moment diagram. Okay. That is actually the trapezoidal rule for finding out the area of the bending moment diagram. And I have done the calculation as well. So you will get this total area. Okay. This is the total area you're going to get for the problem. Okay. So you can see these are in the order of 225, 200. Definitely 1200 something is the answer. Okay, if you just take the average, maybe by, you can say 144 is the average value. 144 into 10, that comes around 1400. So which you can say that the answer is correct, isn't it? So I'm just judging whether my answer is right or wrong. So it's a crude way of judging. See. How do you do that? So actually the maximum ordinate is 225, right? So we can just imagine average rectangle. Okay, I'll just show you. So you can imagine a average rectangle like this. Okay, it may come, yeah, something like that. So thinking that the ordinate will be you just take some ordinate here. So 144, let us assume 144 into the total length is 10 meter. 10 into 144, how much?
1440.
Isn't it? 10 into 144. 1440. Yes, correct. So approximately it is nearest to that. So that means our answer is correct. That way we should judge. Sometimes what will happen is, this A value will come around, let's say 10, 20, or sometimes it will be 10 lakhs, 20 lakhs. That may be because of error you might have done in this calculation. Okay. So that time you should realize whether it is right or wrong by looking at the figure itself. By looking at the figure itself, you should be able to say what may be the range of answer. Okay. So that's how you should be keep thinking always when you are, solving any civil engineering problem or any problem. So you need to have common sense. Okay. So this is the second problem. Okay. All of you clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Let us now move on to the next problem. Okay. So this is a partial UDL problem. Now let us move on to the next UVL, but the other type 2 UVL. So in this case of UVL, you will have a maximum ordinate. I think you might have solved this kind of problem, right? In strength of materials.
Yes.
You might have found actually reactions R1 and R2. Also you might have found the bending moment diagram, shear force diagram. So those actually will be like this. You might have got, this is the shear force diagram and this is the bending moment diagram. This meeting will end in 10 minutes. I have only 10 minutes. Okay. I'll quickly go through it. Okay. So now what will be the reactions here? So how do we find the reaction? Okay, so how do we find the reaction? It's symmetrical problem, no? It is symmetrical. The load is symmetrical, yes or no? Hello? Hello, reply me. Hello?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Yes, sir. Yeah, this is a symmetrical problem, right? This W will be here, okay, and it's a symmetrical one. And what will be the reactions? So if you have a UDL, what will be the reaction? UDL of W into L divided by 2, right?
WL by 2.
WL by 2. If it is in this case, actually it will be half load will go to this side and half load will go to this side. And actually speaking, what is the total load? Total load is nothing but, let's say, if consider small w as the intensity over here. Actually, this capital W is the total load, okay, in this problem. Small, okay, let us assume small w as the intensity of UEL at center point. What will be the total load acting due to this UEL? That's nothing but area of this triangle, right? What is the area of the triangle? Half into W into length L, isn't it? So that will be the total load. Therefore, reaction R1 and R2 will be equal to how much? R, actually speaking, because of the symmetry.
WL by 4.
Yeah, R is equal to WL by 2 divided by 2. That will become WL by
4,
isn't it? So that is what it will be. Whereas here, this W is nothing but total load. Total load is nothing but WL by 2. So therefore, R will be equal to WL by 2 by 2, WL by 4. Okay. So that's how you will get the reaction R. So W by 2. And then you can also find out the maximum or moment at x equation. You can consider moment at x equation. How do you find the moment at x equation? So for which you need to consider a section over here. Okay. Let us consider a section over here at a distance x from this end, and you will be knowing the maximum ordinate over here. Okay, maximum ordinate over here, and which you can, So by similar triangles, you will be able to get the maximum ordinate over here. Actually speaking, if this is W, and if this is x. So if W is there for a distance of L by 2, okay, the value of ordinate is W at L by 2, what it is at X. Okay. So that you can get it from similar triangles. Okay. And why do we need this one? For finding out bending moment at X equation. Okay. Bending moment at X. So W, so W, what will be this ordinate then? So what is it at X? So that will be nothing but, if you cross multiply, you will get this is equal to 2WX by L.
2WX by L.
Isn't it? This will go to the numerator. Isn't it? And this will come to denominator. Therefore, ordinate over here will be ordinate at x, O at x is equal to 2wx by L. Okay. So that is the value over here. Then you need to calculate the area of this triangle for finding out the moment. So now finally, the maximum bending moment, you will get it by this equation. If you simplify it, okay, if you calculate the bending moment at X, you just refer to some strength of materials textbook, okay? You will be able to see, you will be able to find moment at X. I'll just repeat if you want, okay? I'll take it. So just remember what X over here. I'll take some other color. So let us, okay. Now all of you are clear, right? You will be able to get this W as well. I mean, if you have W as this ordinate, you can calculate this ordinate by similar triangles, which you get it like this. This is the value. Now after getting this, what you have to do? You should calculate moment at X. What is moment at X? Moment at X is nothing but R into X. Okay, because we are taking a moment about this point, R into X, okay, R into X, that is the clockwise moment, minus, what is the total load due to this triangle which is there on the left side of the section?
WL by 2.
Bipin, did you join?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, so what will be the total load now? Half into area of the triangle. That's nothing but area of this smaller triangle. Yeah. So which is equal to half into
WL by 2.
Half, it's not WL by 2 because this ordinate is actually OX. Okay. That ordinate is OX. OX is equal to 2WX by L. Okay. 2WX by L is the formula. So which is equal to half into base. Base is X.
Into 2WX by
L. Yeah, into 2WX divided by L. Okay. So after simplifying, so this is how you will calculate the moment at X. And after you simplify further, you will get this equation. Okay. Or you can just keep it in capital W. That's nothing but WL by 2. So WL divided by 4 will be the W. So, or you can have in this form as well. You need not keep it in W. Okay, total load. You can keep it in your small W as well. So which may be simpler. Okay. Using this equation, what you should do is you need to calculate bending moments at different points. Okay. Yeah. So which we have here. So the previous one. So you will have actually this is not the one. So I'll just remove this. It's not this. Yeah. So you will have only one region from here to here. Actually speaking, because of the symmetry, the other side also from the right hand side, if you calculate, you will get the these alternates. Okay. What you need to do is you must this will come here. There's a 12, right? In this, okay, let me explain. This is actually the problem is you have length as 12 meter, W is 60 meters, and you are supposed to find out bending moment ordinate at every 1 meter interval. Okay, so this is actually general the given problem. Okay, so you should calculate MX equation reactions and MX equation majorly. Using those MX equation, you just calculate all the ordinates, okay, just like this, by using the above formulas, okay. And what is the reaction you'll get? Actually, I've done that problem, okay, here, simply supported with the UVL's type 2 problem. Yeah, this is the problem, okay. Reaction you'll get equal to WL by 2. This is total W, W is 60, right? In our problem, okay, I'm sorry. W. So thing is, if you just click, if you have gone, if you, the advantage of preparing this kind of Excel sheet is, if you have done any wrong, okay, any errors, you can rectify very easily. Thanks for watching. Like, share, subscribe, press bell button for latest updates.